Welcoming Steve to the Hall of Fame is Don Nelson. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Nash.
I was never ever supposed to be here. That's for sure. It's incredible feeling to walk up those stairs. You know, you got Nelly off of Maui, and you got both of us in a coat. So this is a big night. So first, I'd like to thank the Hall. This is an incredible part of our game to be curating and reliving the history of the game. It's a beautiful part of sharing what the foundations of this game are and what these generations of kids coming behind the generation before them get to know about our beautiful game. To go into the Hall with this class is incredible. Grant Hill, one of my favorite teammates of all time and an incredible basketball player. Ray Allen, in the same draft, competed against each other our whole career. To watch you set records and win championships, an incredible honor for me to go in with you. Jason Kidd, he's only a year older than me, but I looked up to him the whole way. We go back to college, working out in summers and playing against each other, and then following his career in the NBA, and to play with him and to go in the Hall of Fame with him is incredible. So thank all of you. Of course. The rest of our class is so diverse and done so many things for the game of basketball. It's a privilege to, I could go on about each of them and how much they amaze me for the things they've accomplished. So I'll just say it's a real honor to go in with all of you guys. Thank you. of course. I'm gonna try to be as brief as possible. I wrote some notes down. This won't be 7 seconds or less, but you know, I have some thank yous to make, and I want to thank the fans. You know, that's why we're here. There's interest and demand for our game, and for all of you who have put your time and energy into watching and supporting our game around the world, for all the people that have stopped me in all corners of the earth and have proven that our game is truly global now. It's incredible. It blows my mind to this day, and I'm very grateful for all of you fans. Yes. My mom and dad, I know I'm not the best at doing it, but I love you guys so much, and you guys provided an incredible home for us and upbringing. You taught us so many great values that allowed us to be parents, brothers, sisters, friends, and I'll be forever grateful for your love and support. It just blows my mind, and I try to emulate you guys every day. Thank you. My brother, Martin, we're a little less than 2 years apart. We grew up battling together every day, playing whatever sport it was. He was an incredible athlete. He was a better athlete than me. Just ask him. And he means the world to me, and those memories will live on forever. Thank you. To my sister, JoJo, when I went away to college at 18, she was 12 years old. It's a strange time to leave your baby sister, but what I will say is, over the years, watching her build a family and be the best mom I've ever seen is truly inspiring. And I love you, Joe. To my wife, Leela, I don't have the words to say what you've meant in my life and how you've changed my life and how you've brought peace and balance and slowed everything down and made it all make sense. And the love you give Luca, Mateo, Lola, and Bella is incredible. So I can't wait for the rest of our lives together. Thank you. Wow. I started playing this game when I was 13 years old. I went to a new school, and I met these guys. Al, Mark, Jamie, Adam, and Clance. And they were the jocks. But for some reason, at this new school, these guys played basketball. I grew up playing soccer and hockey, and this was a new game to me. But it was about the same time that Michael Jordan burst onto the scene, and I'd never seen anything like it. And I fell in love with it right away. We played on the eighth grade team. We were overconfident and cocky, and we formed a bond that was unbelievable. We played before school, lunchtime, after school, and that love and passion for the game is the thread of everything that I've accomplished. We were lucky enough to play for Lanny and Chef in junior high. These guys taught us there's a right way to do things. You know, sometimes you look back and you think you know so much now, and you remember years and years ago that these men put their time and energy into helping you and taught you these lessons. So we appreciate you, Lanny and Chef. Ian Heidley was my high school coach. Details and preparation. It's amazing how far they can take you, but it's amazing how underappreciated they are at a younger age. To this day, and all the way through my career, Hides was a mentor and somebody that I called upon for advice on and off the court. But his basketball acumen is incredible, and he shared so many insights with me that made me rethink the game. I thank you. Hyde sent out 30 tapes to colleges around the United States. It was my dream to play Division I basketball. Nobody really liked what they saw on those tapes. but what they couldn't see on the tapes was a relentless obsession and work ethic that would never diminish for 20 plus years. I remember in high school, I went to the Las Vegas Invitational, and I thought this could be my chance to be spotted by a college coach. We didn't get many in Victoria, British Columbia, you know, all those years ago. And we walked into the gym, and it was packed, and there was Hall of Fame coaches there. Coach K, Roy Williams, you know, go down the line, Bobby Knight, Jason Kidd's playing in the gym. I thought, this is my chance, you know, this is my chance. Before the little fellas from British Columbia could get on the court, they all left. So that was my chance out the window. I'll have to come another day. I had one scholarship offer to Santa Clara University. I admit I'd never heard of it, but I jumped at the chance, and it was an incredible, incredible time of my life. Those teammates that I played with at Santa Clara, many of them are here today, are still very, very close friends of mine, and that's a very special time in my life, so thank you, Santa Clara. Our coach at Santa Clara was Dick Davey, and as he would say, he taught us tough-mindedness. What he really did, he taught us mental toughness. He challenged us every day. He didn't care about makes and misses. He cared about playing the right way and being mentally tougher than the competition. And those lessons he gave me and those challenges he provided with me every day are the reason I overcame so many obstacles and I'm standing here. So Coach Davey, I thank you. My first chance to play for my country, Canada. I played for Ken Shields. Yeah, give it up for Canada. Stop it, Grant. Grant's going to say I'm the second favorite Canadian. Obviously, Tamia. Ken Shields was the first person to give me that opportunity. Brought me out to practices with the national team when I was 16 in high school. Nobody thought I passed the eye test. He saw something in me. He mentored me. He taught us discipline. His teams were uncompromising and well-drilled. And definitely a formative figure in my basketball career. After college, I got drafted by the Phoenix Suns. Jerry Colangelo, who's done so much for the game of basketball, not only chair of the Hall of Fame, USAB, incredible impact as an owner, president, general manager, I believe even coach at one point, if I'm not mistaken. He's the godfather of the game in this country. He drafted me. We crossed paths many times during my career, but I'm forever grateful for Jerry Colangelo. My first coach was Cotton Fitzsimmons. He was a legend in Phoenix, incredibly popular. Cotton retired about 3 weeks into my first season. I got to play for Danny Ainge. Man, yes, man, that was fun. That was fun. He taught us to have no fear, and he certainly didn't because he played me, Jason, Kevin Johnson, and Rex Chapman at the same time. I remember playing one-on-one. Danny had recently retired, and we'd be playing one-on-one almost every day before practice. And we're battling, and he looks up at the clock, and he's like, what time is it? It's 7 minutes after when practice should have started. He goes, yells down the other end of the court, where is everybody? Someone goes, I don't know. He turns, throws me the ball, and goes, check ball. We kept playing. It's fun. It's fun to beat your coach one-on-one. You can't say anything, so. And I think it got me some playing time, though. Oh, Donnie Nelson, his assistant coach in Phoenix, yes, Donnie, not this one, his son Donnie, assistant coach in Phoenix, believed in me from high school, arranged for me to meet Tim Hardaway in Seattle to show me how physical NBA guards were and to see, you know, how much size and strength I'd have to put on. That never really came to fruition, but but his support in me was incredible, and was my assistant coach in Phoenix, was a big part of bringing me to Dallas, and I appreciate all the support through the years. Nelly, I mean, this Hall of Famer is one of a kind. Wow, I mean, he taught us to outthink our opponents. He saw the game in a slightly different way, as you could tell by some of our matchups, some of our game plans. He helped write the rules for much of the modern game, and he had some cheat sheets that he shared with us through the years, and he made me really think differently about the game. Most importantly for me personally, though, Nelly taught me to be aggressive to score. I was very shy. I always wanted to pass, set up my teammates, and Nelly demanded that I score, and it changed everything for me. That's a big reason why I'm standing here today. So thank you, Nelly. I got to play with Michael Finley and Dirk Nowitzki in Dallas. And those two guys mean the world to me. It was a transformative stage of our careers. Mike was becoming an all-star. Dirk and I, joining the worst team in the league, were barely NBA players. We pushed each other. I can't remember how many times Dirk and I went back to the gym every night, one-on-one. Horse, conditioning, pushing each other. Many times I had to convince him how good he was. But together with Mike leading us, teaching us, allowing us to surpass him at some point, it was an incredible time in my life. I'm forever grateful. I remember watching film one night with Nelly after we lost. He had the whole team in there. Actually, we won this game, but Nelly was pissed. And he was telling us, showing us how we laid an egg. You know, and Dirk and I were just starting to become good NBA players. But I had to continually convince Dirk that. I think he still thought, like, no, I don't know that we can make it in this league. And so Nelly's showing the fourth quarter, and we're cutting corners, not moving the ball, lazy. And late in the game, I beat my man, got in the lane, and scored. And Nelly goes, well, sometimes talent wins. Dirk looks at me and goes, talent? I mean, it was funny, but it kind of pissed me off. Mark Cuban bought the team during our run in Dallas. His relentless energy challenged and changed the way the NBA is today. I admire it, and I thank you, Mark. The greatest experience of my career was playing in the Olympic Games for Canada. My coach was Jay Triano. Jay was a hero to me, recruited me in high school, and taught me to love the game, and always said, shooting is like breathing. You got to do it every day to live. I appreciate you, Jay. Robert Sarver, Andy Kohlberg, Dick Heckman, the owners of the Phoenix Suns who bought it from Jerry Colangelo. Their first matter of business was to go recruit a 30-year-old point guard in Dallas after they bought the team. I don't think Robert was happy spending a lot of money on the first day on the team on an old stiff at point guard, but they did it, and it was a magical time in my career, and I appreciate your support. You guys made it fun. Thank you. Mike D'Antoni. Mike was the coach for my greatest years as a basketball player. He was a brilliant, he is a brilliant coach, but for me, he was obviously, 100 years ago, was a brilliant basketball coach. He taught us not to care what anyone else thought. Run it down their throats, put pressure on them the entire game, and make them pay. And I'll never forget that attitude, that spirit, and those lessons. Thanks for those great years, Mike. Alvin Gentry, he coached the hell out of an aging team. I think we were picked 13th in the West. We got a couple games from the NBA Finals. It was one of the funnest years I've ever had in my career, so thank you, Alvin. Phoenix's training staff, Mafia. They're getting a lot of love tonight. These guys, Aaron, Mike, Jay, Eric, Tom, these guys kept me on the court, were friends, they were honest, and they allowed us to get through, not just physically, but mentally. I love you guys. Thank you. In Phoenix, I got to play with Amar'e Stoudemire. I didn't really watch a lot of film when I played. I certainly don't like to look back now, but whenever something comes across my timeline or I see a pick and roll with Amar'e, it makes me smile. I mean, this guy was the ultimate target for a point guard. He made the game a lot of fun. Thank you, Amar'e. Dr. Buss. I got to meet Dr. Buss shortly before he passed. He still had that rascal in his eyes, scheming another championship. Our conversation was incredible. I thank him and everyone at the Los Angeles Lakers for supporting me through the toughest time of my career. I've never worked so hard to make anything happen and not get there, but I appreciate all the love and support I got from the Buss family and the Laker organization. To my agent, Bill Duffy, he's been with me the entire way, from college, through my career, post-career. He's a mentor, a supporter. His values, his family have always set an example for me. I appreciate you, Duff. Thank you. Rick Celebrini. Many of you don't know him, but he's been a big brother, a mentor, and a world-class physical therapist who taught me how to move, taught me how to play, and taught me how to embody the spirit that this game was meant to be played with. He's the godfather to my youngest, Luca, and he means everything to me. Thank you, Ricardo. I'm going to direct this to Lola, Bella, Matteo, and Luca, and all the other kids with their life in front of them. I mean, I think you guys know how much you mean to me. I Guy loves a camera, but you guys know, I mean, the rest of you probably don't see a lot of me, and that's largely because I want to be home with these guys, and that's a priority and something that I won't miss for anything. For all of you kids out there, just like these four, find something you love to do. Do it every day. Be obsessed. Balance can come later. Use your imagination. Put pen to paper. Declare your intentions. Set small goals. Knock them off, set more goals. Gain momentum. Build confidence. Grow a deep belief. Outwork people. Play the long game. You don't have to be the chosen one. The secret is to build the resolve and spirit to enjoy the plateaus. The times when it doesn't feel like you're improving and you question why you're doing this. If you're patient, the plateaus will become springboards. Finally, never stop striving, reaching for your goals until you get there. But the truth is, even when you get there, even when you get here, standing on this stage, it's the striving, fighting, pushing yourself to the limit every day that you'll miss and you'll long for. You'll never be more alive than when you give something everything you have. Thank you.